Hey there, geologists! Bea here from the Miiverse. In our last lesson, we learned that Earth's surface is divided into large pieces called tectonic plates that move beneath our feet. So today, we have a special expedition for you. Our team will be traveling to three different locations across the globe to investigate how tectonic plate movement impacts our world. What are some things you think we might find? Only one way to find out. So if you're ready, geologists, let's get to digging. Hey geologists, Fiona here, and I'm so excited to be in Iceland. Notice anything interesting behind me? That's Mount Hekla, one of Iceland's most famous volcanoes. In fact, it's one of many volcanoes here. But why does Iceland have so many volcanoes? Let's look at our map of the tectonic plates. Does anything stand out? Iceland is located at a plate boundary right where two tectonic plates meet. There are three different kinds of plate boundaries, and the first we'll focus on is a divergent boundary. To learn more, I know the perfect location. Welcome, geologists, to Silfra, Iceland's most famous dive and snorkel site. Here you can literally swim between two tectonic plates at a plate boundary, which is so cool. Scientists have been measuring the gap between these plates, and it turns out it's been widening by about 2 centimeters every year. So with this in mind, and what you may already know about the word divergent, what do you think happens to tectonic plates at a divergent boundary? Pause and record your thoughts in your notes. Diverge means to separate. So at a divergent boundary, plates are moving apart from each other. As plates pull apart, they leave a gap for magma to escape from the mantle. And this means... you got it! Volcanoes. It's why Iceland is covered in them. Minor earthquakes are common as well. There are about 80 a day here. Luckily, most are barely noticeable. Now, without further ado, I'm off to do some scuba dive, more research. But don't worry, Helen is waiting at the next location, so you're in capable hands. Thanks, Fiona. Geologists, welcome to Nepal. Notice anything about the landscape here? Behind me are the Himalayas, the highest mountains in the world, which include Mount Everest. Have you ever wondered how mountains like these are formed? Well, if we look at our map again, what do you think we'll find? You got it. We're standing near a plate boundary. However, this particular boundary is a convergent boundary. Based on what you may already know about the word converge, what do you think happens to tectonic plates at a convergent boundary? Pause and record your thoughts in your notes. Since converge means come together, a convergent boundary is when plates move into one another. To picture what's happening here, I want you to put your fingers together like this. Now lightly push them together while relaxing your fingers. Notice how the tips of your fingers bend upward? The same thing happens to Earth's continents when plates converge. So if you've ever enjoyed a mountain view, you probably have a convergent boundary to thank for that. But that's not the only way convergent boundaries affect us. They can also cause volcanoes, earthquakes, and even tsunamis as plates push together. More on how these things occur in a bit, but for now, let's head back to the States to see what B is up to. Hey there, geologists! This little creek might not seem like a big deal, but it runs across one of the most famous plate boundaries in the U.S. The San Andreas Fault in California. This is a transform boundary where tectonic plates slide past each other in opposite directions. Along this plate boundary, earthquakes are fairly common. Why do you think that is? Imagine tectonic plates as two slices of pizza in a pan. As one slice is pulled out of the pizza, bits of crust grate against the neighboring slice along their shared edge, leaving crumbs in the wake. A similar thing is happening to Earth's crust at the San Andreas Fault, but the movement is so slow we can't usually tell it's happening. Now, imagine this same pizza scenario, but this time the pizza slice is poorly cut and stuck in place. When it's pulled, it stubbornly hangs on, until eventually it yanks free in a sudden motion, shaking all the toppings in the process. Now imagine if there were tiny people on the pizza. This same thing can happen to Earth's crust. The rocky edges of the plates become interlocked together and pressure builds as they try to move. Eventually, they break free and the crust moves several inches or a few feet all at once. This sudden plate movement creates shock waves that we call an earthquake. The bigger the gridlock between the plates, the bigger the earthquake. Which is why stronger earthquakes tend to occur at transform and convergent boundaries, where plates are most likely to get stuck. And when this happens in the ocean, the shock waves can cause tsunamis. As you can see, even though Earth's plates only move a few centimeters each year, they can have enormous consequences for those of us living on them. This also means there are a lot of benefits to studying them. Geologists, what do you think are some benefits of studying plate boundaries? Pause and record your thoughts in your notes. Let's look at a few examples of these benefits out in the world. Ever seen barriers like this at a beach and wondered what they're for? Or maybe seen buildings like these on the west coast of the US? These barriers help block or slow down big waves caused by tsunamis or storms. And as for these buildings, their unique structure provides extra support in the event of earthquakes. Areas where natural disasters are common often have clearly established evacuation routes, zoning laws, and emergency shelters to help keep people safe. Most of these protocols for disasters are established with the help of geologists who understand how and why these disasters occur. It's a huge benefit of studying plate boundaries, but the benefits don't end there. Studying plate boundaries also helps us locate important natural resources, understand Earth's changing landscape, and determine how these changes might affect us in the long term. That way, we can make informed decisions about ourselves and the planet that we live on. And speaking of our planet, let's review what we've learned about it today. At divergent boundaries of the Earth, plates pull apart. At convergent boundaries, they push together, and at transform boundaries, they slide past each other. All of these boundaries have a large impact on Earth's landscape, causing natural disasters such as earthquakes, tsunamis, and volcanoes. Studying them allows us to better understand Earth's changing structure and how it affects us. Next time, we'll dive even deeper into plate tectonics as we explore how boundaries impact the sea floor. Until then, remember, small shifts can create big changes, so don't underestimate the impact you can have. Stay observant, keep asking questions, and I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.